골을 뚫어버리죠. That's familiar, this girl. I don't know whether I've taped her before or not, or videoed her. Mako-chan? Wait. Is it Mako-chan? That's Jim Lee's most artwork for, what should we call it? What is it called? Hush, yep, that's Hush. Author Jeff Loeb and artist Jim Lee. That's because it's got 52 minutes, that means I've been filming for 2 hours already. 2 hours. Time for a cigarette break. It's bloody hot around here. actually I'm thinking about leaving after 3 hours. Hours is just too much for one event. I'm not getting the feeling for this cosplay event at all. It's definitely different from the one in the Cosplay Invasion number 3. Cosplay Invasion number 3 is smaller, but at least it's not as crowded as here. This one I just don't like it. It's just too crowded. Belts are so sexy.
No idea. To me, it's cool.
Guys who saw us are having killing the duck from what do you call it, the video.
Thank you.
Whether it can go inside the any maximum. No more. See the character there? That one is the same character as Karen, cute gangster Karen. I thought it was a special type of creation by Karen from comic Invasion number 3.
Yes,
now. I think Karen's character is much better than this. Karen of Kampar, that is. Cute gangster. I'm just mimicking Karen. Still do not know the name of the character, that character with the funny hoodie. No idea, actually. Oh, they're playing cards, isn't it? So when it comes to, say, this cosplay, it always comes with cards, playing of cards. Have I missed my chance to go inside? No idea. Pet shop is there, side.
Very
One, two, 5,000 signed up to up now. Queue up here. Oh, is it there?
Huh?
Queue up.
Yeah.
Why are they queuing up there?
Huh?
Why are they queuing up there? Why are they queuing up around the ring?
With the number.
Oh, oh, okay. If it's from here to there, that means it's a bit small, the booth, that is, the size of it. Even the PC fair is more bigger than this. It is the cosplayers that make the event memorable and not these things here. But at least they organize the thing, the event, so it gives an opportunity to the cosplayers to come about and show their colors. Why is there a line there?
get a free gift for coming coming to this event here. So at least it's worth the wait, I guess. What the hell is this actually? No idea. What in the world is this thing? I'm not sure actually. No idea what it is. Oh yeah, this is a strap thing to put on your bag thingy. Oh, that's what it is. Actually, no, I don't think so. I don't know what the hell it is for. So is this like the PC fair? It's the same old shit. There's a line somewhere, it's going somewhere, but I'm not gonna like go on a great line. So let's go and take a look. It's a very small expo. Was this dedication corner? What I'm supposed to like go this way, right?
It's Rishi Mata B6 Mata M2. So the answer is B2 B6, right? That is absolutely correct! So B6 and F5, Shafi, for the second time you got 2 points! Whoa, it seems like Shafi is leading the race already. Okay, since just now, right, our friends over here trying to cheat like blow very fast. When I say start blowing, only you blow, okay? Alright, okay, the next question goes like this. 3, 2, 1, next! Stop blowing! Shafi! I wonder, you are good in bursting balloon or you are good in anime knowledge. Alright, question number 4. Look for the two characters. Bleach and Naruto one. Yeah, the first one is from Bleach, the second one is from Naruto. This is... I'm not Angela, so don't be nervous. Alright, so the next question, Number 5, go! 3, 2, 1, next! Shafiq, think properly. Check out boy quickly! Shafiq again! Seriously? Shafiq, you better know the answer, I tell you. E3? Ash! Don't tell Shafiq, I don't want him to win. C3 and E3. C3 is Ibarra, and E3 is complete. Right? Confirm now. No second chance already. So, for the third time, Shafiq.
Let's go and see some merchandising. So you got all the pillows there. Mugs as well. Mugs up here. Show your support for your favorite anime. Ah! Shingeki no Kyojin. The SD ones? Oh, I think on the Titans very popular. You can see the Colossus Titan there. You get a Colossus pillow, head, thingy. And also One Piece. Of course, One Piece is number one in terms of manga, and Shingeki no Kyojin is number two. So that's why there are more One Piece and more Shingeki no Kyojin. Let's get out of here. I'm back at the start of the line. Get out of here.
Chinese oil, don't cut it.
Thank you. Stanley, how are you?
Hey.
Where's your girlfriend?
I don't have a girlfriend.
Oh, where's Melody Choi?
Oh, she's not here.
Oh, okay. So how are you enjoying this this Animax?
Well, one word. Exhausted.
Exhausting?
Yes. Because I'm wearing double and it's cotton.
Cotton.
So all my sweat is sucked up and remain on my clothes. So it's like,
Okay, that's a bit too much information.
Oh yeah.
But never mind, you can divulge it.
Yeah.
So your whole gang is not around?
Oh no, on the second day.
Oh, second day?
Yes.
Oh, who's coming? The
Naruto.
Your partner, is it?
Oh, my classmate.
Oh, your classmate?
Yeah.
Normally when it comes to cosplay, it's always two people supporting each other, isn't it?
Yeah. It's not a very big society, you know.
Oh, you belong to a society, yeah?
Sorry?
You belong to a society, yeah? Do you? Cosplay eventing?
No.
It's more of a friend...
A friend group. Mutual friends and acquaintances, yeah.
Ah, okay. So, what do you think about this Animax, this venue?
It's okay.
It's okay?
Yeah. Maybe a little bit crowded.
Ah, too crowded, right?
Yeah.
It's very hard for you to, like, swing your big sword around, right?
Not as crowded as last year, yeah.
Last year, the Animax, is it?
Yes, at Sunway.
Sunway?
That's more crowded.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Some people I've interviewed, they say it's much nicer in Sunway because it's bigger.
But then, when during the lineup, we were lining under the sun.
Under the sun?
For 2 hours.
What?
So...
I thought it's inside Sunway Pyramid.
But the line was long.
Wow,
so
too long.
Went out. So, give or take. Yeah.
Oh, you mean just to enter something like this?
Yes.
Okay, but there's nothing to see actually.
So same as last year when we do.
Oh, there's nothing interesting.
New anime shows.
Oh,
it's just for the games.
Oh, games. Do you want mine?
Yeah, I want a few of the games.
Uh huh.
I lost one.
Okay, well, can you tell me what the hell is this thing?
I don't know. It's some kind of pouch. It's a pentabox.
Oh. What?
Pencil.
Put pencils inside.
Yes.
It opens up the whole thing.
Yes, opens up it.
Yeah. Is it a Japanese thing?
Should be.
Oh, okay.
Is there creative way to do
it? Okay. So are you cosplaying?
Yeah, I used to cosplay.
Oh, used to cosplay, but not anymore.
Not anymore.
Why is that?
Kirito. Sora to.
Well, I mean, you used to cosplay, you're not cosplaying anymore.
Yes.
But in the future, you're going to cosplay, right?
Sort of, maybe.
Maybe, yeah. So, do you think it's very exhausting to cosplay?
Well, walk around under the sun sometimes when it's sweaty.
Under the sun? Sunway, I don't understand. You have to line up to enter Sunway Pyramid or the booth?
The booth. Like lining up right here.
Uh-huh.
But here's indoor everything.
Uh-huh.
In Sunway, it went out to the outside.
Wow.
Yeah.
Oh, they diverted you out lah.
I don't know, it's just people line up and just...
Oh, it's a very, 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 very long line until very... Okay. So, I think I'm not going to stay here for long already. It's
crowded.
No, there's nothing much to see.
I don't know, I don't see many very awesome cosplayers around. Like Comic Fiesta, there were a lot of good cosplayers, I think.
Yeah, like Gundam, there's one.
Ah, there's Gundam as well, but a lot of pretty girls are, right?
Maybe tomorrow there is.
Tomorrow? Why would you say today and tomorrow is different?
Today will be much more crowded because the entry is only for people that has Astro Bill.
What? I just came inside without the Astro Bill.
I don't know. If you have Astro Bill, you can get free gifts, right? Yes. You say yourself, right? I thought entry only.
Quite a lot of confusion, getting the number and waiting.
I think it's a merchandise. A lot of people is buying the starting first because on the second day they won't be selling much.
Oh, okay. So any awesome cosplayers that you have seen besides yourself?
No. I can't consider myself also.
Okay.
A few.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Name some.
No, I don't know their names.
So what are the characters they will play?
They have nice armor.
Do that again?
Armor.
You're talking about breasts, right?
No.
No. Oh, okay. Nice. I thought it's a new type of it's a new phrase for, you know. You calling it armor already, or you calling it personality, big personality?
Well, I did not say armor.
Oh, armor. It's like armor, you know, to me. Because it's very hard to penetrate the armor.
Whoa.
Not you. You're too flat chested already.
Well, I know.
So you'll be here tomorrow?
Yes.
Definitely, yeah. So when's the next cosplay event?
Around me.
The C2-ish,
yes,
something.
C2-ish.
What does this stand for?
Comic, cosplay, anime, games, exhibition.
Oh, is it as big as this one?
Bigger.
The venue is in what? Jalan?
The Chan Sao Lin.
Huh?
It should be at the Chan Sao Lin. You know the Chan Sao Lin area? Near the Help College?
Help College. Where is it? In KL?
Yes, KL. Chan Sao Lin.
So it's a college type of event, right?
Yes.
Okay. So,
yeah.
Shit. I've been...
Alright. Well,
thank you, Stanley. Just show your face.
No.
What? Last time you showed me before?
This time is messy.
Huh?
It's messy this time.
Messy, yeah, because of your makeup. Okay, thank you very much. Okay. Here you go. The video will be some there.
Okay,
thank you. So that's the end of this thing. Quite a small expo, very small indeed. So San Lee, who is as Atake Kakashi, says tomorrow it might be nicer or bigger, who knows.
If you would like a picture with Iron Man and Mr. Dancing Griffin, please come forward and form a line. You will have 10 photo opportunities.
I got 9 more minutes on this 3-hour event. Maybe I'll wait until tomorrow. Maybe I'll come back. Not bad.
Today is the 30th of March 2014, it's a Sunday, and it's 10:23 PM. So today I'm going to make a video on why I did not attend a cosplay number... Here we go, okay, I'm ready. So on your left is Animax 2014 in... Mid Valley in KL. So on your right would be, of course, Cosplay Invasion number 3 in Penang Times Square. So two different places, two different venues, two entirely different experiences, but one vision, which is cosplay. And I am not really, I have never done cosplay before, but I've done videos about cosplays. My first foray into this cosplay thing is CF Comic Fiesta 2013 last December. So Stan Lee, who plays quite a good Kakashi Sensei from Naruto cosplay. So JY Clobber says he is Stanley's friend, and why didn't you record day 2? I was there cosplaying Naruto. Sorry about that, JY Clobber. I wasn't feeling well, as in I was pretty sad because of the number of videos that I have to upload, and the more videos I make, the more work I have, the sadder I get, if there is such a thing as a word as sadder. So this would be my thoughts on cosplays. Yes, So cosplay is something that people do every day, even though they are not young. Adults do cosplay, but it's an entirely different cosplay. Cosplay that, well, if they go to work, they have to like dress up. They dress their best, and that's a kind of cosplay. Although they don't wear a wig, and not much colorful, what you call it, uniform. Not colorful costume, and no knives or guns or plastic swords. That's the difference between cosplaying in everyday life and also cosplaying in events like Cosplay Invasion and also Animex thing. So my thoughts about the two of them, normally for me, I prefer to do only one day. I really do not like to do 2 days of cosplaying, which is kind of like not so good actually, from my perspective, because, well, today I wanted to go to day two, but I opted to actually sleep. Slept from like 1 p.m. to 6 p.m. just to try to stop myself from going to day two. I wanted to go to day two, but I stopped myself from doing it. It's becoming an obsessive compulsive disorder to actually want to film all these cosplays. When I was in, okay, 1 week before this Animex cosplay, there was this Cosplay Invasion number 3 in Penang. I did day 1 and day 2. I think day 1 was 6 hours of filming and day 2 was 5 hours of filming, so that's a lot of hours going around with my camera and shooting the shit out of everybody. So it was very exhausting, and you have to have a lot of adrenaline to do so and a lot of enthusiasm. And I guess I've exhausted both qualities or both stuff, as in enthusiasm and also, what was the other one? Enthusiasm and also adrenaline. Yes, yeah, you have to have those two qualities to shoot hours and hours of video. And previously, or before this Cosplay Invasion number 3 in Penang, I was around Penang, going around Penang shooting other stuff like food and tourism stuff for 5 or 6 hours a day. So wow, it was just quite a lot of work to do actually. And I haven't even uploaded those yet. And I have a lot of videos to upload, and it was like driving me nuts thinking about it. And I got sad and just wanted to crawl and not crawl, to just go into a ball or fetus-like posture and sleep and not think about redoing anymore. So cosplaying is quite nice to actually look at all the efforts of everybody around, but I'm the type of person who actually does not like to be in crowds, and also I am quite a shy person and I do not like to talk to people. Very, very strange, isn't it, to actually find out that I am a sort of person. What would they call that type of person? Is it, it's not pessimism, it's not go-getter. It's, don't remember the word. Okay, this simple thing is, I'm a shy person. I do not like to be around a lot of people and talk to people. My natural state is I just shut the fuck up and I just walk around. But when it comes to like having a camera around, I change myself and I just do whatever I do, which is to talk to people or want to find out what inspires them to cosplay. And interviewing people is very, very taxing indeed. When I have to like say meet a new person, it's already a event by itself, and I have to ask them questions. I have to work my small little puny brain. I have to like think of things to keep the conversation going, And bear in mind, I have never ever seen them before or met them before. Nope. Except for Stanley. Oh, okay. This one here, is, you see this girl here? She's one of the cutest girls in Invasion, cosplay Invasion. Yeah. So, where was I? Ito. Yeah, I got a lot of work to do. I have to do like Shingeki no Kyojin chapters, which I've neglected for some time now. Neglected it because other people have not asked me to do it, thank God. I got so many things to do. So what is the difference between cosplay, this Animax cosplay on the left, and this cosplay Evasion number 3 on the right? Both venues, if you compare size by size, I would say that the Animax one is bigger. Yeah, in terms of size, that is. And the one in this cosplay Invasion number 3 is slightly smaller. But if you ask me personally, I prefer the one in cosplay Invasion number 3. You look at the space around this place here, in this small little, quite a big, okay, quite big area. You can see that there are a lot of empty space. Yeah, a lot of space, thank God for that. Oh, and there's the prettiest girl here, I mean the cutest one. There is a lot of space, and that is very conducive for me to move around and also to capture the moment, moment to moment of what the cosplayers do, and also to creep out all the girls, that is. that's not, I don't want to creep them out, but it's just what I do. I mean the camera, yeah, the camcorder. So these are two Malay girls, if I'm not mistaken. Not many Malays in this cosplay Invasion number 3. Unfortunately, I did not get the chance to like talk to the two basketball Malay girls. Again, when it comes to like interviewing people, there are a lot of situations that that prompts me to like talk to them. As I said earlier, I do not like to talk to people, and I do not like crowds. So some of them is like purely chance. When I talk to them, it's a chance thing. When at the right moment I was near them and I feel like talking to somebody, and they are not engaged in anything else, they are just walking around, there are not many people around them, then I would actually go and engage them and talk to them. Many situations need to be ticked for me to talk to them. So in the cosplay Invasion number 3, again, you see all the videos, there are a lot of space, a lot of white walls as well. So it's very, very nice for me. I can move around, I won't bump into other people, thank God. And yeah, you can see there, so many empty space. Of course, you can check the videos out, the 10 hours of videoing around this this small little cosplay. And you can see one of the organizers, I think his name is Miao. He cosplayed as a girl, a very ugly one, that is, very, very ugly. And you check out the one in Animax. Animax is a clusterfuck, fucking clusterfuck. It was not conducive for me to film at all. There were so many people walking around. Cosplayers were a lot as well. I don't know, maybe the okay, now I can see her. Now I only realized this. But you look at this one here. What's her name? Shit. Hikari. Shit. I got the card here. Hikara. Yep, Hikara is here. I thought I did not get her at all. There were so many cosplayers, so I do not know what the fuck is happening. So Hikara here is playing the prince or the dragon in the Spirited Away Studio Ghibli movie. So she's here. I just realized that. And of course, oh, this one here, you look at cosplay Invasion number 3. this is one of the most impressive cosplayers ever. I mean, from my point of view, only after the cosplay invasion number 3 did I realize, after going through my videos, that this girl here, definitely is a girl, who carries a block of wood, and she portrays one of the animes which really bought the shit out of me. I think that's the anime that she was portraying. It's something about ghost and whatnot. The art style of that anime, I think, is very very unique. But the story is damn fucking boring. It's some about spirits and whatnot. The last episode that I slogged through, I don't know what's the name of the anime that I slogged through, was, I think the character was in or on a ship, and there were like people in it, and they were talking about something about spirits and whatnot, and that's fucking hell, it's so boring, I just stopped watching it. I bought it, inverted commas, bought it because there were like good reviews of it, and I watched it, and nope, I don't agree with the reviews at all. Bear in mind, the art style is okay, the art style is unique, but fuck, it's boring as fuck. Pardon my French. So this person here, I think I would say this is the most impressive of all of the cosplayers. Don't get me wrong, there were a lot of impressive cosplayers in comic. What was it? Cosplay Invasion number 3. But this one grabs me the most, grabs my attention the most. Although I did not interview her, I didn't have the chance. As I said earlier, there are a lot of situations that prompts me to talk to people. You won't actually get what you want. She was very popular, a lot of people were photographing her, so I have no chance to actually approach her and ask for an interview. So, okay, now I'm actually doing a review of everything.
I'm also carrying the bag. I think it's hard to like walk with all these things. Very hard. I'm also carrying the bag. I think maybe it's kind of heavy. It looks like a real box indeed. What the hell? Is that the middle finger? I think it is a fourth finger. What the hell? I think maybe it's kind of heavy. It looks like a real box indeed. What the hell? Is that the middle finger? I think it is a fourth finger.
So I don't know whether she did the middle finger, and this is the venom causing a havoc around Cosplay Invasion number 3. So where was I? What was I? Why was I making this video? Oh yeah, to say sorry to Clobber for not doing day 2 and also doing some reviews on all this cosplays. I'm not the sort of person to actually love to edit and show you pictures of which cosplayers impressed me the most. When it comes to this Animax, I did not see any. I mean, the cosplayers are impressive indeed, but I haven't formed any thoughts on it at all. Let's see here. Oh yeah. And one of the most one of the prettiest girls that I've seen in this Cosplay Invasion number 3 is route somewhere. No idea. This one here. This one is one of the, I think, the cutest one. I'm not so sure, but a very impressive cosplay as well. The maid thingy stuff. And I am having some suspicion on. When it comes to like cosplay, it's very very difficult for me to like say recognize people. Just now you've seen Hikara, right? Hikara was playing that Studio Ghibli character which I first that which she cosplayed in this Animax, and I did not recognize her at all. In this cosplay invasion number 3, that pretty girl which I'm trying to find now, this one here, having the knives, very very scary, and a very nice cosplay made thingy. Do not know what's the name of the character, God knows. Indeed, but very cute face, of course. I'm having some suspicions that the person here is actually the girl who had that wooden box on her back. I think so. I'm not so sure. I do not know at all. No idea. But I have some suspicion. It just came about a couple of days ago. I was thinking when I looked at the most impressive cosplay video. I mean, I just saw the picture and look at the face. They do actually look a bit similar, indeed, very similar. But I do not know. I'm not sure, not 100% sure. So when it comes to like say makeup and wigs and other costumes, they went day one, day two, they change their cosplays, and then suddenly fuck, I do not know what the fuck is happening. And also, there's one more thing here, that just now the maid cosplayers actually thought that this girl was her, this fellow here, God knows, wearing red stilettos. They had the same similar features, but this one here. So I do not recognize all these people at all. Sometimes I recognize them, sometimes I do not recognize them at all. So God knows. There's quite a lot of spectacles that this girl is wearing here. This is quite a cute Yui, I think. Okay, I think that's about it. There's nothing else to say. Bye bye.